I'm Stephanie Charles, a technical sales associate with Omron, and in this video, I'll be going over some of the features, benefits, proper use, and the overall importance of Omron emergency stop devices, such as the A22 series of e-stops. Not only are our e-stops compliant with safety regulations, including ISO 13850, we also have a variety of emergency stops that can be used to simplify installation and ones capable of handling your toughest environments. The modular design of the A22 series makes common maintenance tasks simple, and it also allows for easier troubleshooting and repair. The great news is we also sell these parts separately. So for example, in the event that a part becomes damaged, you can replace just that part rather than repurchasing the entire unit, which really helps cut down cost. We also have models that features push and plus terminal blocks, which provides higher vibration resistance and secure wiring. Additionally, there's a lock detection feature here that adds an extra latching mechanism and an emergency shutdown to help keep personnel safe. For those of you with applications in harsh environments, we also have a variety of robust and reliable emergency stops that are IP69K rated, such as this one, which is suitable for applications that are subjected to washdowns, areas subjected to dust, and much, much more. Lastly, we have illuminated options that assures visibility and safety for operators, which will also perform great in poorly lit environments. Now, concerning the proper use of these, there are some consumers who may believe that as long as the e-stop can stop their machine in sufficient time, then nothing else matters. However, there's much more to it than that. According to safety standards, safety products require the ability to monitor and the ability to be reset manually. It's also important to keep in mind that e-stops are required to be easily accessible. This is because usually when someone is in distress, they tend to use the palm of their hands. Therefore, when they attempt to hit the actuator, you don't want any surrounding parts impeding that process. Did you know that according to safety specialists, e-stops are the most common safety violation found in safety risk assessments? For example, current standards require a yellow background for the e-stop, since a yellow background makes it the easiest to notice. Adding a yellow background is one of the simplest violations to correct. Are you wondering what other potential hazards may be lurking in your facility? No need to worry, as Omron provides safety risk assessment services. This can include everything from the initial hazard analysis, remedy options, documentation, to full mediation. If you want to learn more about safety standards, another option is to attend one of Omron's available classes. Offerings include a bootcamp for beginners or the advanced TUV functional safety for engineering certifications. That concludes this brief video on Omron emergency stop devices. I hope you found it helpful. If you'd like to learn more about these e-stops or any of Omron's other safety products, you can visit our website at automation.omron.com. Thank you.